Social media giant Facebook adds a new method to remove misinformation in groups. Administrators can automatically send misinformation to a so-called quarantine queue. Facebook says the new tool is meant to ensure that content published in groups are reliable. The new feature comes ahead of the U.S. midterm elections in November. Now, Facebook's parent Meta also wants to fend off critics who say it doesn't do enough to fight misinformation on its platforms. Businesses will thrive here in the Philippines. That declaration coming from President Marcos during the 48th Philippine Business Conference and Expo in Manila. Speaking at the event, Marcos recognized the role of businesses as drivers of economic growth as the Philippines recovers from the pandemic. He then vowed to continue improving the business climate in the country. He's also seeking to elevate the status of the Philippines as a top investment destination, while also prioritizing local businesses.
We recognize the fact that our businesses cannot thrive alone. Thus, it is my commitment to foster a sound environment where businesses can flourish. We will need to work together in coming up with more infrastructure projects, more energy projects, more projects for our MSMEs, more projects for agriculture, all that will empower and strengthen both our economy and our nation. Do know that the government is unwavering in its commitment to make the Philippines a viable option for businesses, both for local and foreign investors.
Here at home, Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says he will no longer pursue the country's military chopper deal with Russia. He was responding to Russia's request for the Philippines to honor a previously signed contract to buy 16 military transport helicopters from Moscow. The Philippines agreed in November to pay $227 million for 16 Mi-17 choppers. But the Duterte administration decided to cancel the deal due to fears of Western sanctions after Russia invaded Ukraine. Now, Marcos says the government has already found another supplier for the choppers.
The deal with Russia was for some heavy lift helicopters, and now we have secured an alternative supply from the United States through the manufacturer Poland. In any case, meron na tayong kapalit. So, unfortunately, we made a down payment that we are hoping to negotiate to get at least a percentage of that back. But the deal as it stood, at the beginning or in the middle of last year, has already been canceled, and we have, secured another alternative supply for those helicopters that we need.
But Russian Ambassador Marat Pavlov says Moscow continues to fulfill obligations regarding the contract because it has yet to receive any official communication from Manila on the termination of the deal. President Marcos wants Filipinos to stop treating the COVID-19 pandemic as an emergency. The chief executive says the country should already start going back to normal to spur economic growth.
We have to get away from the emergency. The emergency stance of the DOH, because we have to open up businesses. We have to make the Philippines more hospitable to travelers, both business and tourists. We must treat COVID no longer as an emergency, but something that we will have to manage forever. It's like flu, like pneumonia.
But Marcos says he will not lift the nationwide state of calamity yet, as the government still has to resolve several non-health issues.
Pag tinanggal ko yung state of calamity, hindi makukuha ng ating mga health.
They got the spike protein.
Now, the Philippine government, urged by a health expert, to already secure bivalent vaccines to combat new COVID variants. Infectious diseases specialist Dr. Ronjin Sonante says these can be administered as a third booster dose for vulnerable populations. His plea comes amid the rise of more vaccine-resistant COVID subvariants, like the XBB strain, which has already entered the country.
That is why it's bivalent, because you have the spike protein of the original Wuhan and the spike protein of the subvariant of your Omicron. targeting B1, B4, and B5. Comparing it with the monovalent, the neutralizing antibody was superbly higher. And they tested the antibody against the Omicron, B4, the B5, and also the BA.1, and higher protection, maintaining its protection also against the Alpha, the Beta.
Solanda himself has received a Moderna bivalent dose in the U.S.